At first glance, nothing seems so profoundly varied, so essentially distinct, as the diverse substances that comprise the world. So, does matter consist of one or many elements? One single primitive element. The bodies you regard as simple are not true elements, but rather transformations of the one primitive matter. Where do the different properties of matter come from? From the modifications that the elementary molecules undergo as a result of their combining under certain conditions. Do molecules have a constant or variable form? Constant for the primitive elementary molecules, but variable for the secondary ones, which are only aggregations of the former. However, what you term a molecule is still very far from being the elementary molecule. As has already been demonstrated, the universal cosmic fluid is the primitive elementary matter, whose modifications and transformations comprise the innumerable variety of bodies found in nature. As the universal elementary principle, it offers two distinct states, etherization or imponderability, which may be considered the normal primitive state, and materialization or ponderability, which is in a certain way only consecutive to the former. The intermediary point is the transformation of the fluid into tangible matter. However, even then, there is not a brusque transition, because our imponderable fluids may be regarded as a halfway phase between the two states. Each of these two states necessarily gives rise to special phenomena. To the latter belong those of the visible world, and to the former, those of the invisible world. Some, called material phenomena, are within the jurisdiction of science per se. The others, qualified as spirit or psychic phenomena because they are most specially connected with the existence of spirits, fall within the attributions of Spiritism.